Hello everyone, I am Sujoy and I am back with another exciting Operation Sister tutorial for you. So this is the part 3 of the video where I am telling you how to solve a 5x5 transportation problem by stepping stone method. So in the part 1 of the video, we talked about the definition of stepping stone method. We found the initial basic feasible solution or initial cost, and also we checked for degeneracy. In the part 2, we found all the loops for all unoccupied cells. So following the technique described in step 2 of the video or part 2 of the video, you can find out all the loops for all unoccupied cells. So I have already calculated them for you. So here are the loops. You can pause the video here and note down all of them. Now in part 3 of this video, we'll start from the optimality test or step number 3. So in step 3 of stepping stone method, we'll do the optimality test. So after drawing or writing down all the loops for all unoccupied cells for the matrix, next what you have to do, you have to do the optimality test. So there are the rules for optimality test. Rule number 1, examine the total cost for each loop or each path and check if any loop has a negative total cost. So in our question, we had two negative cost values, one for the cell or for the loop O1 D1, which has the negative value -2, and another for the cell or the loop O5 D1. Again, which has the same negative cost value, which is -2. And for your kind information, the O1 D1 denotes the cell O1 D1 and O5 D1 denotes the cell, this cell, where the row number is O5 and column number is D1. Rule number 2, if all cost values are greater than or equals to 0, the present solution is optimal. Rule number 3, if any total cost value is negative, then the present allocation solution is not optimal and we need reallocation. So here is our observation. Since for loops O1 D1 and O5 D1, the cost values are negative, our present allocation solution is not optimal. We need reallocation. That we'll do in step 4. Step 4, reallocation. So again, there are some rules for reallocation. Rule number 1, locate the loop or the path which has the most negative cost. So in our question, we have a tie. We have two same most negative value and both the values are -2. So we have a tie. Rule number 2, draw the path in a separate matrix. That means, till now, we have only calculated the loops, we did not draw them directly on the matrix. So what we have to do, we have to write down this matrix separately or freshly, and we have to draw that loop or that loops only which has the most negative value. So here we have, if we have two or more same most negative cost value as in our case, then draw two separate loops and evaluate them separately. But in my observation, I have found that if we have two same negative most negative cost value, then we can draw only one loop and from that we should get the optimal transportation cost. Rule number 3, for reallocation, find out the smallest allocation value in the path of loop. Consider only the corner cells. An allocation will not be considered in calculation if that is not a corner cell. So we have to draw two loops, one for the position O5D1 which has the negative value, and another for the location O1D1 which has the negative value. Basically, since we have two same negative cost value, we have to draw two separate loops. If we had only one most negative value or if we have more than negative values, more than one negative values, but one of them is the most negative, then we'll go with that loop only. So first we'll draw our loop 1 for the cell O5D1. So let's draw the loop. The loop is a path which starts from an unallocated cell, which travels throughout the matrix over the allocated cells only, and which ultimately ends at the same cell from which it started. That is, it's a closed loop. And in the path of loop, we can't have 3 or more than 3 adjacent allocated cells in a same row on a same column. So for example, here we have 2 adjacent allocated cells, this cell here and this cell here. But if we had another cell here, we couldn't have drawn the loop because that will violate that rule. So let's draw the loop. Our first cell will be the plus cell, which is given in the rule number 4. Starting cell of loop will be the plus cell, next cell minus cell, next plus, next minus, and so on. So first cell will be the plus cell, drawing a straight line from that cell, coming to our next allocated cell, because loop can travel only over the allocated cells. So next cell or next corner cell will be the minus cell, and from the allocated cell we can take a bend. So we can't go forward this side because there is no allocation. Basically we can come to this cell from this cell we can't go anywhere else. So we are not going to this cell, we are stopping to this allocated cell. So this cell is the minus cell. Next we have to go only upward because we can't go down or we can't go right. So going upward, coming to our next allocated cell, which is the cell O1D2, which is the plus cell. Next we can't go left side because there is no allocation, and we can't go up, we have to go only right. So going right, this is our next allocated cell, which is the cell O1D3. This will be the minus cell, and from here we can't go right, we can't go up, we have to go only down. So coming down, this is our next allocated cell, cell O4D3. This will be the plus cell. Again, we are not stopping at this cell because from this cell we can't go left or right. We are considering only the cell O4D3. Now from the cell O4D3 we can't go left, we can't go down, we also can't go upward, we have to go only right side. So coming right, this is our next allocated cell O4D4. This will be the minus cell because previous cell was a plus cell. And from here we will go up to the cell O3D4, which is the cell, so this is the plus cell. From here again we can't go up or right, we have to go only left. So going left, we have reached to our next allocated cell, which is O3D1, and from here we can't go up or forward, we have to go only down. So coming downward, we have reached to our starting cell or originating cell. So the loop is complete because loop has to be a closed loop. Now we'll do the reallocation. So rule number 3 for reallocation. For reallocation, find out the smallest allocation value in the path of loop. Consider only corner cells. Corner cells are those cells in which the loop takes a bend. So this is our corner cell, this is another corner cell, this is another corner cell, and so on. So for calculation, we'll consider only the corner cells, not the cells which are in the path of loop. So this cell, although which is in the path of loop, but this cell will not be considered in calculation since this cell is not a corner cell. I am talking about the cell O2T3. So an allocation will not be considered in calculation if that is not a corner cell. And finally, applying rule number 5. So first, for reallocation, find out the smallest allocation value in the path of loop. So in the path of loop, the allocation values are considered only the present allocation value, which are given in the black color. So starting cell O5D1 don't have any allocation. Next cell O5D2 has the allocation value 5. Next cell O1D2 has the allocation value 3. Next allocation 3, next allocation 2, next allocation 8, next allocation 2, and next allocation 2. So among all the allocation values, the smallest allocation value is 2. So we'll take that value and consider only the corner cells. Now the rule number 5 says that add that value with the present allocation value in plus cells and subtract that value from the present allocation value in minus cells, and so on. So our starting cell is the plus cell, so we'll add that value with the present allocation value in that cell. So present allocation value is 0, so 0 plus 2 is 2 is our new allocation for the cell O5D1. Next cell is the minus cell with the present allocation 5. So 5 minus 2 is 3 is our new allocation for the cell O5D2. Our next corner cell is O1D2 with present allocation 3. So 3 plus 2 is 5 is our new allocation. Next cell is O1D3 with present allocation 3. So this cell is minus cell. 3 minus 2 is 1, our new allocation. Coming to next cell, which is O4D3 with present allocation value 2. So 2 plus 2 is 4, since this is the plus cell. Next cell is O4D4, which is the minus cell. Present allocation 8 minus 2, 6 is our new allocation. Next cell O3D4, which is the plus cell. Present allocation 2 plus 2, 4 is our new allocation. And finally, next cell O3D1 with present allocation 2, and this is the minus cell. So 2 minus 2, 0 is our new allocation. In other words, this allocation is removed. But we have created a new allocation at the cell O5D1. So the total number of allocations is not changed, but the allocation values are changed. Now after the reallocation, how to know if our present allocation is correct or not? For that, again remember in part 1 I told that for any row, the sum of total allocation value is equal to this outside value. So previously the allocations were 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. But right now they are 5 plus 1, which is equal to 6 again. So for row O1, our allocation is correct. Similarly, do the check for all the rows, and that is true for all the columns also. For example, in column D3, previously the allocations were 3 plus 2 plus 2, that is equal to 7. But right now the allocations are 1 plus 2. Because for cell O2D3, no reallocation is done. So for the cells where allocation is done, consider the newer allocations. And for the cells where no allocation is done, consider the old allocation values. So right now the allocations are 1 plus 2, 3 plus 4, which is equal to 7, which is again equal to the outside value or the demand value. So similarly, do the check for all columns also, and we can verify that our looping solution is correct by that. Isn't it cool? So this is the end of the part 3 of the video. How was the video? Let me know in the comments below. If you like the video, please like and share the video. Your comments, likes and share really encourage me to make more quality videos in future. I have already uploaded more than 55 videos on operation research covering the transportation problem, assignment problem, K queuing theory, game theory, linear programming problems or LPPs, that is simplex method, network analysis or project management. I have videos on all of the topics. So if you want to watch any of my previous videos, link to all of them is given in the video description below. So thanks for watching. See you in my next video. And still then, stay connected by subscribing.